On February 23rd, 2014, on the wind-scoured streets of Worcester, Massachusetts, a cadre of lunatics, savants, and freaks were drawn to a local dive bar on a frigid Wednesday evening. Were they drawn there by fate, destiny, or, much more likely, boredom and casual alcoholism? History may never reveal the answer, but one thing is certain. They were seeking a new way to tell a story. And what a story it has become. What are we? We are an improvised writing competition. We are a roving performance troupe. We are not a cult. We are a joyful reverie of peculiar verbosity. We are a destination for the wonderful and a refuge for the strange. We are a fucking party machine. We will challenge you. We will stupefy you. We will entertain you. We will leave an impression. Who are we? We are the Federation of Belligerent Writers, and here tonight, for the first time ever, we have some stories to share with you. Tonight, as ancient grudges are settled and a war is waged for the honor of wearing the Tiny Hat of Mischief, the Federation of Belligerent Writers brings you our most revolutionary show ever, Sindependence Day. 5 minutes. Three words, one champion, Boston, we have arrived.
United Kingdom, the greatest kingdom, the United Kingdom, the greatest kingdom.
Boo. Boo.
I love you, you tart. Welcome to FBW's Sindependence Day.
Fuck this, I'm drinking already.
Our enigmatic and mysterious leader, El Locutor Fabuloso, could not host this evening.
He
suffered neck injuries that were not at all consistent with a jealous rival beating him over the head with an umbrella. So, it has fallen to me to come and entertain you this evening. I will host the show for you all, and by the end of the night, the United Kingdom will recolonize the United States. It is going to happen. You can boo all you like, you traitors, you traitors. Tonight we have assembled for you the bracket. Eight of the finest and most talented performing writers in the world today.
Yeah!
Or at least what America can offer. Tonight you will be entertained. Every one of them will be facing off head to head in a tournament to decide who will win the Tiny Hat of Mischief.
Ooh. Tiny hat!
about this tiny hat of mischief over the course of the night. It is one of the most legendary items that the Federation of Belligerent Riders can bestow upon its champion. And there are 8 people here tonight who are going to compete to win it. Now, who here has been to an FBW show before? For the rest of you, welcome.
Yeah!
You're in for a treat.
Fresh fish! Fresh fish! Fresh fish! Fresh fish!
Fresh fish!
Hey, you want to explain how it works?
Yes, I'm explaining how it works.
Well, you're new and all, so, you know.
Yes, yes,
you didn't
yes,
even
yes.
tell them who the fuck I
Over
am.
Over to I'm my left, first. This loudmouth little piece of crumpet.
Hi!
This loudmouth little piece of crumpet is bad bitch Becky.
Yeah!
She will be our stage manager for the evening. Now, as each competitor will come to the stage 2 at a time to face off, head to head against each other, they will take a seat either in the red corner or the blue corner. They will be given 5 minutes, and they will be given 3 random words chosen by bad bitch Becky's internet. They will need to use these 3 words in some form of writing, be it a poem, a sonnet, a short story, a battle rap, a eulogy. It gets weird.
Erotic fan
fiction.
Woo! We have had Harry Potter erotic fan fiction. We have had a lot of weird things. They will then read their stories aloud to you, the audience, who will vote on which one you would like to move on to the next round. And by the end of the night, we will crown the champion. The champion who will win the tiny hat of mischief. Was that sufficient enough for you, bad bitch Becky?
Yes!
Yes. Shall we start this evening's festivities off? Is that all right with you?
Yeah, I guess.
I guess. All right.
Whenever you're ready.
The first match of the evening is a blockbuster match. I would like to introduce to you first one of the winningest champions in FBW history, a legend in her own right. I would like you to put your hands together for the Princess Consuela Bananahammock!
Loyal subjects for coming out to see me today. I'm so happy to be here. I'm so happy that you're here. I can't wait to see Ronalda. I haven't seen her in so long, and I'm sure that you're all gonna be really happy to see her too. I just can't wait. I'm so happy. You guys are beautiful. I can't, oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay.
Princess Consuela Bananahammock in the blue corner. Now, introducing to you in the red corner, another multi-time FBW champion and the only FBW champion ever to win an FBW show outside of Central Massachusetts.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that one.
Oh, that's right. Scoff Wellington remembers everything. Please welcome Ronalda, the Intergalactic Super-Pimp!
I got holes. In different area codes.
Hello, my wonderful fans. It is so nice to see you here this evening. And hello to everyone I have not met yet. I cannot wait to spread the love to Somerville.
Yeah!
Ronaldo and Princess. Bad bitch Becky.
Yeah?
Do we have 3 words to give to these intrepid performers?
Sure. How about coral? Like the stuff in the coral reef.
Coral! Acceptable.
Yes. Geologists, like guys that would study the coral stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
Geologists.
Yeah. And twang. Like a southern
is
twang.
Is that an American? I feel like that's an American thing. I don't.
Yeah,
like, Britain does not have twang.
No, you just got whatever the fuck you're doing right now.
Is that twine? But with a no.
No, it's twang.
It's twang.
Twang.
Okay, yes.
Geologist. Coral.
Twine. Twang.
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 There it is.
Twang.
Sure. Go
poor old geologist and twang.
Yeah.
All right. Now, while they write, we will be playing music for a dance party that you all can partake in. You can also throw little Nerf projectiles at them to try to interrupt them, make them lose their focus. This is a challenge! So challenge them. Let's put some time on the clock, bad bitch Becky.
Yeah, I got 5 minutes. You want to do this?
We count it down from what?
I don't know. You pick. What do you want to do? Like 7?
6?
5?
4? 3?
2? 1?
Now. All right, let's get on to why you're here this evening. The intrepid words. We'll start off in the blue corner. Miss Princess Consuela Bananahammock.
Hi. They said this. I'm sorry, they said this was easier. Okay, I got it. I'm sorry. All right, I'm not used to this mechanism. Hi, all right. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful princess, and I'm sorry, hold on. Can I ask you a question? Does this, like, fanny pack match my dress?
Yeah!
Good, because, like, I thought it was inappropriate, because this has got, like, a paler pink, and this is more of a coral, but I'm wearing it because I need to keep my phone close by in case of Pokemon. Oh, and that lure outside? You're welcome. Just a little bribery. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful princess, and her name was Consuela Bananahammock, of course. And she was walking her dog through the vast and beautiful fields of her beautiful fairy kingdom for the 7th or 8th time today. And she came across this adorable little pond as she stopped to capture a Magikarp floating in the pond. But alas, every time she tried to capture him, she failed. And it's not just because she's fucking terrible at that part. It's when she realized it was not an adorable, addictive digital creature at all, but an actual fish. And it was speaking to her. Hey, baby, it said in a thick southern twang. I'm sorry, I'm a princess. I'm not good at doing voices that are men, but that's a manfish, I swear, and it's a southern fish. Okay, pretend this is a manfish. Okay, so anyway, he said, princess, I thought you should know I'm a magical geologist. If you kiss me, I shall cease to be a fish and transform into a handsome rock man. Golly, said the princess, that sounds really tough. How do you feel about that? And, well, honestly, princess, I'd feel a lot better if you put a big smackaroo on my sexy, slippery fish lips and let me sweep you off your feet with my vast knowledge of geodes. And, golly, that's a really swell offer, she said, but I'm gonna have to decline. You seem like a nice fish and all, but God fucking bitches these days. You aren't even hot, he said. I bet if I was a prince, you'd kiss me, you gold-digging whore. That's not very very nice, the magnanimous, beautiful princess said. And that's when her beautiful fiancé came slipping through the forest with her beautiful bag full of beautiful dog turds. You ready to go, honey, she said. And she said, golly, thank me, getting me away from this fucking fish pie.
Princess with her fairy tale for this evening. Now let's throw it over to her challenger for the evening. Ronalda, the Intergalactic Super-Pimp!
Hello everyone, it is fantastic to be here. Today is all about freedom. It is what I love about this country. We have the freedom, of course, to throw things. The freedom to sin. The freedom to drink. Try my intergalactic Cosmo. It is a Cosmo with grenadine, sweet and sexy, available at the bar. And of course, most importantly, the freedom to love who you love and be who you are. Scoff Wellington is here to threaten that. Here to threaten our way of life. Well, Scoff Wellington fancies himself many things. A politician, a mathematician, a geologist, but he knows nothing of geography. I have traveled many lands, everywhere. I have heard the twang of the Alabama iguana, and even found legendary evidence of the semen troll in the deep coral reefs of Neptune. Ooh. And of course, I have seen many worlds and many countries overtaking each other. It is stupid. It is petty. We should all be united. And the one thing that can unite us all is love. I am here to prove tonight that even Scoff Wellington's cold British heart can be melted. If only we find him love. And I will find it. Sindependence Day has always been my favorite holiday. Of course, the only time I have seen fireworks is from outer space. Or, of course, when I see two people I have hooked up truly falling in love. But this year, I finally got to see them in person. And I understand the true meaning of Sindependence Day. Is being in a country where you have the privilege to pretend to blow shit up.
Ronaldo.
All right, now for the fun shit. I know we ran out of paddles, I'm so sorry, and there's like shit for network in here, so that app thing that I gave some of you is not gonna work. That's my bad. I don't know what to tell you. So if you got a paddle, now's the time to raise them up. Red side for the super pimp lady, blue side for princess, and ready, Scoff, this is how we do it. I know you're not used to this, but you count.
Yes, yes, explain it to me. Condescend to me, American. Let's go. Let's go. I want to hear this.
You count the red side, I count the blue side, because I'm on the blue side and you're on the red side.
Okay, got that. Who counts green?
Go fuck yourself.
Okay. All right. So well, I have blue.
One. No. Oh, you got it. Excellent. One.
Team yellow. He has a picture.
Team yellow. Team yellow. Come on, yellow.
Team Pokemon. Team purple. Pokemon, go. Gotta count them all. Gotta count them all.
What do you have,
I got 40 blue. First of all, that is the most I have ever counted for any show I've ever done. I'm surprised I got that high. I didn't even have to take my shoes off.
I have 76 green.
There is no green, motherfucker.
All right, fine.
You limey bastard. What?
Fine, 18 red.
Oh, the blues have it.
Princess Consuela Bananahammock is moving on to the next round. So let's move right on to our second match of the first round. Shake, 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 shake the body like a rock.